what I'm tracking right now. Although things are quiet in Anniston, this is our storm team tower cam in Weber at the higher elevations there. But we're looking off towards Ohatchee, where rain has just moved out. Temperatures in Anniston right now at 85. You add in a little humidity, it feels more like 91 out there. But we are starting to see those late day showers develop, all because of the warm air. It's heating up the ground. That air rises, and with that rising motion of the atmosphere, we'll pop off a few of these scattered showers and storms. Tuscaloosa Vance seeing some light rain, near Hueytown getting some light rain, and then back towards Sylacauga, right along Highway 280. Most of this wet weather is moving off to the northwest at this time. And as we move through the afternoon and evening hours, I think by midnight, we'll start to see the air calm down just a bit. No rain, not a lot of rain overnight tonight. Temperatures overnight in the 70s, but tomorrow we will see the return of some wet weather. A lot like today, a dry start and even a sunny start to your Thursday, followed by those afternoon pop-up showers and storms. But here's where we really start to see some changes in the forecast. After sunset Thursday, just when you think the rain is going to be moving out, a cold front begins pressing in from the north. It will start raining quite a bit in the Tennessee Valley just before midnight Thursday. That will prompt a few prefrontal showers in the northernmost part of our viewing area late Thursday night. Heaviest rainfall, though, expected to arrive early Friday morning from Hamilton, Jasper, Coleman, Asheville over towards Gadsden. It's going to be a messy start to our Friday with that morning commute, and then that rain will continue through Friday afternoon. I'll let you know if this rain sticks around for your holiday weekend, though. That's coming up in your Storm Team 7-Day Forecast.